What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel. This might be the first video you're seeing. Today, I'm gonna be filming my house tour video. If you watch my videos, you might know this has been a long time coming. I've lived in this house for over 2 years. I wanted to say also that I'm renting this house. I don't own this house. I love watching home tours. I am obsessed with home decor. I've really, especially with this house, gotten a lot more into, I feel like, my personal style with designing a home myself and trying to figure out how to do that with not really having help and just what I like and what works and what doesn't work. And my personal style. I'm gonna have links in the description box down below to almost everything. Like whatever of my furniture is available online, which is a lot of it. Like furniture, like decor pieces and little things, I'm gonna have links to it down below. Thumbs up this video if you're excited to watch it, and let's go ahead and get into it. Hello guys, welcome to my home. We're decorated for fall, so we have our little wreath up and stuff, but come on in and I'll show you guys all around. So this is my entryway. We basically just have a little bench here for putting on shoes, a rug. I'm gonna tell you guys where like everything's from in this video, just so you know. People always ask where stuff is specifically from. This rug is from Ruggable. Everything I talk about that's available online, I'm gonna have links in the description box down below for you guys, if it's still available, so make sure you go check that out. Right here is just kind of where I have my sunglasses, Squirtle's leash, my purse for heading out the door, and we have little plant. I believe this one is a philodendron, I'm pretty sure. Keep it right by the door, she gets a lot of sun. And then now let's go into my office. So this is my office, you guys. This room was so fun to decorate. It actually took me a really long time to like do this room. We have lots of plants in here. This one I think is a spider plant. This one is amazing. It's one of my biggest plants. I'll put it on the screen. And she is growing while about to be sprouting a new leaf. Amazes me how gigantic these leaves get, you guys. Like 5 times the size of my face, but I love this plant. So good in the corner. Most of my plant pots are from World Market. I think this one's actually from All Modern, but yeah, you gotta have some good plant pots. I have my Rihanna coffee table book that my sister gave me. Best present I've ever gotten. We have some more plants. This is a pothos, and this is a, I think it's called a prayer plant. Down there, these are thriving. They love the light. This is my little workspace area. I come down here and I edit a lot. The desk and this, and basically all this stuff is from Home Goods. And the chair, I think, is from Wayfair. I'll have it linked in the description box. I can't link this stuff because I don't think Home Goods has an online website, but they have great stuff. And lastly, this is probably my favorite wall in the office. I love these shelves. They're actually just from Amazon. You can also get them various places online, but they have this little fake leather strap. I love them. I just have some pictures, some fake plants, a mirror that is also from Home Goods, and then we have this little love seat. The love seat is from overstock.com. I'm obsessed with it. They have it like in a bunch of different colors, so as long as it's available, I'll link it down below for you guys. We have this rug in here too, under the desk area. It's also from Home Goods. Basically the office is sponsored by Home Goods, except they didn't actually sponsor. So that's pretty much the office. This is the other little area of the entryway. We just have the closet here, just some coats and shoes. This is my first level bathroom. So this is probably the least used bathroom of the house, just because honestly, I've never used this shower. Because there's 2 other levels of the house. You guys will see the bathroom that I use. I do use this shower to water my plants that are down here, so she's been used for that. I have a little artwork right here. I didn't really go crazy on this bathroom. I just used stuff from my old house. One of the starring artwork items in the entire house is a portrait of Squirtle my sister got me for Christmas. This was done by her neighbor, Olya. I'll put her Instagram on the screen. If any of you guys want to go check her out, follow her. I mean, it's just amazing. It literally looks exactly like Squirtle. And right here we have my garage. We're not going to go out there, but it's just my car, my bike, a bunch of boxes, and that's about it. So let's go upstairs. Pretending I'm doing 73 questions with Vogue right now, but we are going to go upstairs to the main level of the house. All right, guys, we are upstairs now. This is where I spend like 90% of my time. We have the living room, and the kitchen's over there, which we'll go in a minute. This is my living room. I kind of redid it a few months ago. And right now it also has some fall vibes and additions to it because it's early fall right now. We have my couch. This is probably like my one of my favorite parts of the whole room. This is a vegan leather couch from Albany Park, which is an amazing Black-owned business, and I love that it's a vegan leather because it's actually a lot cheaper than like one of these brown real leather couches. I swear some of them are like $3,000. But I'll link this down in the description box below. I think I have a 10% off code with them. If any of you guys want to check out any of their stuff, they have tons of colors, styles. It's an amazing brand. Squirtle approves. He loves the vegan leather and he pretty much lies here like 80% of the time. This rug is from Ruggable. Basically, I think I have like 4 rugs from Ruggable. I love this one because you can actually throw it in the washer, which I've had to do 2 or 3 times having Mr. Squirtle. Or if you stain it or something. So it's really fluffy, comfy. They have a ton of patterns, colors, everything like that. Then we have my coffee table. This is the newest addition to my house. I ordered this off Etsy. I love the bottom of this coffee table. It's like a rattan. And then I just have a coffee table book, some knickknacks, a little basket with some candy. This is my TV stand, probably another favorite piece of this room. I kind of splurged on this. I usually do not splurge on furniture, but this piece I'm obsessed with and I feel like I'm gonna use it for so many years. It's from All Modern. I like to just put stuff in here and then close it. Looks really presentable. So I have a few coffee table books here. I have a little plant and a vase and some little decor things. I have another little boot here that my sister gave me. Love this. I have my little disco ball. This is my Monstera plant. It's in this really cool stand. This is probably one of my favorite things that I have for my plants. It's from Home Goods. This Monstera is one of my favorite plants. It's super easy to take care of and I love it. Have a little shelf over here decorated for fall. I'm not the best at decorating shelves, but you know, I try. We're gonna go out onto the balcony. Sorry it's dark, by the way. All the light is like coming in right now through these windows. It's kind of on the opposite side of me, but this is my balcony. This is my little sectional I have out here. I can't remember the website I got this on, you guys, but I love it. I've used this thing so many times since I put it out here. We have pillows from Target. We have some fall pillows out here right now. I love sitting out here. I use it the whole spring, summer, fall, basically. And then this table actually came with sectional, which was pretty cool. I just have some fake plants, some candles. One of them's not looking its best. The sun seemed to have burned that, so don't look too close. Let's use my potting soil right here. I'm always repotting plants. I don't really know where else to put that. The rug, by the way, I don't know how good you guys can see it because the sun has really, really faded it. But it's from overstock.com. One of my favorite parts of the balcony too, the egg chair. I think I got it from the Home Depot website because it's the only place I could find it. But I absolutely love it. It came with the cushions. This pillow is from World Market. And then we have this little, I use it as a footrest, but you could also use it as like a mini table. And that's from Serena and Lily, I think. This is my little dining area. I love my tiny little two-person dining area. These chairs are everything to me. They're one of my favorite pieces in my entire house. Pretty sure these are from the brand Polly and Bark. I'm almost positive. I'm trying to remember where everything's from in the house. I think they're called the Wishbone chairs. I'll link them down below for you guys. My little table is from West Elm. And then you guessed it, the rug is from Ruggable. Moving on to some of my plants again. I actually don't know what this one's called. It might be a pothos, but just hangs up there. I have this plant over here. I think this is called an Audrey ficus. And it was not growing for like 2 freaking years. And recently she has spotted a bunch of new leaves. So I'm very proud of this plant right now. It's one of my current favorites. If you guys watch the vlogs, you know it took me about a year and a half to install curtain rods. I finally did that. I think it looks a lot better. This is my snake plant, one of my favorite easy house plants. And it's been growing a lot since I got it. So this is my fiddle leaf fig. When I got this plant, it was about 3 feet tall, maybe. And that was probably 3 years ago. And this thing is about to hit the ceiling. I'm probably gonna have to cut it back a little bit. It is so happy. I don't know why this fiddle leaf fig and me just really get along well. We have another plant up here. I actually painted this pot. This is a little ZZ plant, but the star of the show. So now we're in the kitchen. I feel like everything I say is my favorite part of the house, so I'm just gonna stop saying that. But love the kitchen. It's super, super open. We have this little island. I never ended up putting bar stools here. I think it's just because I live alone. I don't need three bar stools here when I have the table. Once again, we've got the fall vibes. We have our little pumpkins. Over here, I don't really have a full bar cart, so I did a little countertop bar cart thing. And then also, if you guys can see over there, that's my wine bottle shelf and my wine glasses. I think it's from Etsy. I got it for Christmas and I'm obsessed with it. It holds the bottles, it holds the glasses. It also has rim on top, so it's kind of like a 3-in-1. So over here, we have some dish towels, just like basic stuff on top of the oven. And of course, you may be staring at her, the star of the entire kitchen, let alone the house. I got this from a thrift store for $3.99 a couple weeks ago. I just feel like it was made for me. Like, this is the star of my home now, and she will forever be on display. Over here, we have my bread box. We have my, that's where I keep all my produce. That thing's from Target, by the way. I love that thing. This is from Wayfair, the bread box, I think. Deep, like, bagels and obviously bread in there. Lastly, we have our little coffee corner. I mean, this is essential. We have our espresso maker, milk frother, coffee grinder, coffee beans. Only other thing I have in the kitchen is this runner rug, which is also from Ruggable. Off the kitchen, I have my laundry room. I love having this here because so many times I'll have like dirty dish towels, whatever, or I want to throw in things from the living room. So I love having the laundry room right here. Even though I'm renting this house, it came with these like barn, I think that's what they're called, barn sliding doors. I'm obsessed with them. So I just close up the door whenever it gets messy in here. Washer, dryer. My vacuum that changed my life. The Dyson cordless one, game changer, you guys. Tried to make it look cute over here, a little fake plant. I also just love this storage in here. I keep like my little recycling in here. A rod so you can hang up clothes when they're drying. I do that with a ton of my clothes. Okay, this is a little half bathroom on the main level by the laundry room. I love this little rug, you guys. This is a recent purchase from World Market. And then this little shelf. I honestly just keep, yes, extra toilet paper. You see another pumpkin I have. How many mini pumpkins do I have in my house? It is concerning. Somebody comment down below how many you counted in this video. Thanks to my favorite podcast, Girls Gotta Eat, for letting me know about Tushy. This is my bidet attachment. I highly recommend it. Right under my stairs, which we're gonna go up to my room. I kind of made into my own little record player zone. We have this bamboo wall hanging thing. I love this. It's from Urban Outfitters. Online, you could put it over a door. I just think this is super cool. Love it. If they still have this online, I'll link it down below. I have a little pothos over here that hangs. And then just the record player. I use mine like almost every day. I've never done a record collection video, but if you want a little peek, this is it. We've got a lot of Rihanna, Kacey Musgraves, Lorde, Mac Miller, Amy Winehouse, the list goes on. But yeah, I use my record player pretty much every day. This is my burgundy ficus. I'm almost positive it's burgundy ficus. It has these pink undersides of the leaves. This pot that it's in is from World Market. I love that it comes with this plant stand. It's a huge pot, so really good for giant plants. Okay, we're finally gonna go upstairs. I feel like I keep telling you about it, but this is a photo that my friend Cameron Phillips took. This one, I believe, is from Utah, and he was on, I think, Lake Powell. It's so beautiful. Let's go upstairs. I ran out of breath coming upstairs, but we have my room right here. The guest room's over there, which we'll go in after. Up here, I never hung up this mirror. If you're wondering why this is here, it's not supposed to be here. It just sits here. And then we have my YouTube plaques. Classic, every YouTuber shows these in their house tour, but my plaques, they obviously have to be displayed, so they're right there. Okay, we have arrived at my bedroom. I've worked hard on my bedroom for the past few months. I really cleaned it for you guys, just so you know. He just moves to every service that we're at and shows off himself. He pretty much sleeps here every night with me, so it's just as much Squirtle's bed as it is my bed. But my actual bed is very simple. I used to have tons of throw pillows, but honestly, like, I'll tell you guys a secret. I know it's bad, but I do not make my bed most days. So I would just have throw pillows everywhere. It was bad. So I just gotta keep it really simple. I have my sleeping pillows and literally one pillow that's from Target. My actual bedding and sheets are from Brooklinen, and then my bed frame is actually from Lowell, which is where my mattress is from, but I just say that to say that they actually sell bed frames too. I love this one. It's very simple, but I think it looks amazing with the room. Up here we have my little handmade flower wall. I don't get very crafty. This is as crafty as I get, you guys, but I dried flowers and I put them up on the wall. I think it looks amazing and I'll probably keep that for a future room. We just have some hats hung up here over in the corner. I think it looks pretty cute. And then just a little fake plant. This is my nightstand. I just have some fake flowers. I meant to light this candle for you guys, but honestly, I forgot. And my noise canceling machine for when I wake up to construction every day. And then the actual nightstand is from, I think these are from Wayfair. I'll find a link and link them down below. I love them because they have two drawers, so you can really fit like a lot of crap in here, you know. Tell me how he does this every night. I don't know why he stretches out and splutes like this, but tell me how I have a king size bed, but he takes up half of it. Over here, this is like a little random section of my room. I basically have my vanity over here. I also have my mirror that I take a lot of outfit photos and I vlog. And I get ready in this mirror actually more than I do with the vanity. I don't know why I like to sit on the floor. And then this is a vase that I recently got. I think it's from also Wayfair. And Pampas. These are amazing, you guys. They're just fluffy little. I just think they look amazing. And they're dried. So rather than a flower, they last forever. So little Pampas. I got these off Etsy. This is my little vanity corner. Like I said, I use the floor more, but occasionally I do come over here. It's pretty cute. The actual vanity is from overstock.com. I love it. It's a mirrored one. It also came with this fluffy stool. I mean, that makes me feel pretty classy. This wall is a bit random. It initially was like a festival and concert wall. It pretty much still is. Random things have been removed and added to it. So I feel like I'll change this when I go to my next place. It's a little random, but I had to do something to this wall, so I put artwork on it. Under that, we have my bean bag and my squishmallow, which are not usually here. This was in the living room, but then I ran out of room, so it's just chilling in my bedroom for now. These little shelves, I love this. It's in the background of all of my mirror photos. So I kind of wanted to make it cute. This Pothos has been thriving, you guys. She is growing. So this is the only plant I have in my bedroom because Pothos are good with like lower light. And just little knickknacks up here. Cute local artist stuff. Love the shelf. The actual shelf is from Home Goods. No one's surprised. Down here, yes, I'm using my cowgirl boots as decor. Whatever. This is a little fake plant from Target. I have a few fake plants upstairs because like I said, there's not as much light, so it's a lot easier maintenance. Target actually has some really good ones for not that expensive, so that's over there. Under my bed, and to kind of separate my room a little bit, I have this fluffy rug that I love oh so much. I just feel like it kind of matches every space. It's from Overstock, and I've had this for a few years. It has stayed in amazing condition. Luckily, never had to wash it, but I vacuum it all the time. This is my TV that used to be in the living room. I feel like it looks too big in here, but it also needs to be hung up, but it hasn't been, so it's just kind of balancing right there. Also have this little thing. I feel like you could have done more to this wall, but I just kept it very simple. And then we have like two, it's not one dresser, it's two little ones. I'd like to upgrade this the next time I move. These are just from IKEA. They're not exactly the cutest, but they're very functional. And they hold all my folded stuff. I just got this the other day from Etsy. This thing's so cute. I'll link the shop down below. I keep my rings and everyday earrings here. And I'm telling you guys, if you're bad at keeping plants alive, but you want to decorate, Target has the fake plants. Over here, we have my bathroom. Once again, the amazing. What are they called? Farmhouse doors. I don't know, but I love them. We also have Jared's nightstand. Yes, he has his own nightstand. He doesn't live with me, but he has his own nightstand for his side of the bed. Cowboy hats, again, great decor. You can wear it and you can use it as decor. I mean, it's amazing. You just literally hang up a nail, put it on the wall, and that's it. You don't even need wall art. Here's my bathroom. Once again, the amount of storage in here is amazing. We have my perfumes right here, all my products. If you guys watched one of my most recent videos, all my products are in here. We're not going to go through that today. I recently got this little shelf here from Etsy. I think it's so cute. It can't hold much, but it can hold little tiny things, so. Just put some products up there. This is a photo of a succulent that I framed. Jared's sink and my sink. This is my shower, love it. Have a little wooden bench right here with my main products on it. My wooden shower mat thingy. And then these, I love these little bath mats. These are from Pier 1. I like them because they're very neutral and they'll match with any bathroom that I have. Lastly, in my actual bathroom, this is like a separate door to my closet. Love my closet. I feel like it's the perfect amount of space for me. We have my shoes. I recently did a huge clean out, so I have tons of extra hangers. If you guys want to see a full like closet transformation, I'll link that up here. But I think that's it. All right, guys, lastly, this is the guest room. I don't necessarily feel like I needed a guest room, but this house, I kind of just have to decide what to do with this room. And I won't lie, like, I've had a good amount of guests. But also, me and Jared have sleepovers in here sometimes when we feel like, let's just switch it up. The bed is actually maybe comfier than my bed. This room, I didn't hardcore like design. Basically used all stuff from my old house because I didn't need to go all out on the guest room. But I still think this room turned out really cute. As for the bedding, these fluffy pillows are from Pottery Barn. This little one's from Target. The tapestry kind of brings me back to like 2014 days, but I love this tapestry. I think it's so pretty. It's from Urban Outfitters. I have fake greenery. This is really nice, once again, if you're not good with plants, but you want to add like greenery into your space. I think it looks so cute, and it's from Urban Outfitters. I didn't do anything on this wall, so it's just kind of boring. But that mirror that you saw earlier was supposed to hang on this wall, but it's too late. It's not happening. I use this little thing for storage. It's great and cute. We have this little thing, which, once again, you could cover like a door with it, or you could hang it up. It's from Urban, another fake plant. This one's from Target. This is a thrifted nightstand that used to be in my bedroom, but now it has taken over in the guest room. And lastly, super quick, I'll show you guys the bathroom. So this is the guest bathroom. I actually use this bathroom a lot because it has a bathtub. So I take a good amount of baths in here. I love having this bathroom for that reason specifically. Once again, didn't go crazy with decorating it perfectly, but I feel like I did some cute guest bathroom touches. Okay, you guys, that is the whole house tour. I feel like, you know, I like to talk a lot, so I probably made it very long. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you guys wanted to know where any of those main things are from in my house, like I said, I'm gonna have a million links in the description box down below. It's gonna take me a while to put them down there, so make sure you look if you're really interested in anything. But I wanted to do this house tour before I end up moving out. But finally, the house was pretty much ready. So if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and leave me a comment down below telling me like your favorite home decor like shop or like Etsy shop or something fun like that. So I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you soon. Bye.